Hi, welcome to Simply Simple Life. Today I am going to be making aloo parathas. For that we require potatoes. I have taken 4 medium sized potatoes, boiled and peeled them. I am going to be using chili powder, turmeric and salt. It's a very simple recipe, it's a basic recipe. So I'm just going to be using these 3 items to go together with the potatoes to make the stuffing. I've already kneaded up the dough with 2 cups of wheat flour. You can make it medium soft, just like chapati, need not be very stiff or too soft also. I'm taking 1.5 tablespoons of my chili powder. My chili powder is actually my sambar powder. So if you are going with red chili powder, maybe you can go with just 1 tablespoon and that should be enough. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric and 1.5 teaspoons of salt. Combine this together. I'm comfortable using my hands, but if you're not, use a masher or a fork or a larger spoon to combine this together. We have to get it to this consistency and then make small lemon sized balls. Go ahead and roll all of the potatoes into equal sized balls. I got around 16 here with 4 potatoes. My dough is ready. I'm going to be doing the same, rolling them out into similar sized balls. You can see that my stuffing and my outer covering, they are of the same size here. It comes out nice if you have them in the same quantity. Dust the dough with some dry wheat flour and start by thinning out the edges by pressing it with your index finger and your thumb. If this process is something new to you and you're not used to doing this, you can use a rolling pin. The idea here is to get the center to be slightly thicker, denser than the edges. The edges have to be thin. We keep the center a little dense because when we are using the rolling pin to roll out the paratha, it should stretch and not break. So keep the stuffing in the center and start folding. Fold one side on top of the stuffing. Hold it with your thumb. Press down and bring it to the center and keep repeating the process until you make a really nice round ball with it. Now press it down with dry wheat flour. This is just to dust it so that you know it's easier for you to roll and it will not stick to the rolling pin. While rolling it out with a rolling pin, be gentle with it because there is stuffing inside. We don't want it to, you know, break and be coming out. So gently roll it. Keep turning it so that the pressure is applied evenly to all the sides. Don't press too hard on the edges. So dust off all the excess dry flour. And lay it on top of a hot tawa and apply some oil on it. While that is getting cooked, we can go ahead and start rolling out our other parathas. Keep the flame on medium and keep flipping it once in a couple of minutes. And when both sides are evenly cooked, just take it out. Be generous with oil. If you're using ghee or butter also, be generous with it. Parathas taste really nice when, you know, the oil is slightly higher than what we use for chapatis. Just go ahead and finish up all the dough and the stuffing. This is a very simple recipe. You can have it as it is. If you want, you can have it with yogurt, curd, or pickles. It's a very good recipe for lunchbox also. Give it a shot and let me know how it turns out for you. Take care. Bye-bye.